Hey, what's up? It's Jared with State of Tech, and I'm back with another PC build. This will be my second PC build, and if you remember, if you watched the previous one, you know that I'm building a PC mainly as a editing machine, as a creative device. I don't really do a lot of gaming, and this build wouldn't really make sense for somebody who games anyways, but nonetheless, I'm going with an AMD build this time. I've been watching what AMD has been doing back when I built my first PC back in, I think, 1998 or 1999. It was a dual CPU AMD build. So I've been using AMD for a long time. I just haven't been building a lot of PCs lately. So we're going with the Ryzen Threadripper. This is the 1950 series. This is a 16 core, 32 thread. I'm excited about this because I know that Premiere Pro isn't going to be able to utilize all of those cores, but what it's going to allow me to do is multitask while I'm rendering out. It's going to give me that extra CPU performance to do more from within my PC while my PC is actually doing work. So I'm excited about that. We've got the Rogue Zenith Extreme motherboard here, which is definitely the most expensive motherboard I've ever purchased, but it comes packed with a lot of good features. We've got the ability to throw three NVMe SSDs on there, which I'm just gonna start with one. We've got the 960 Pro. I may come back and reconfigure this later in maybe a RAID format with a couple more of those. I don't know. We're just gonna start out here from now. So this is the X399 platform that works with Ryzen here, this Threadripper chipset. We have 64 gigs of Corsair Dominator Platinum RAM. I went with that just because they're big beefy heat sinks on top, comes with fans. I don't need all the LED stuff that also works with that, but nonetheless, it was really good performing RAM for me last time in my previous build, so I'm going with it again. Over on this side, we've got a 1,000-watt power supply, and that should be enough for this build. I originally was thinking about going with 1,300, but I think that might have been a little bit overkill, so we're gonna go with 1,000, which I think should be plenty for what we're doing here. The Kraken X62 cooler, I previously in my last build had a Corsair cooler. I didn't like the way that the pipes exited to return back to the intercooler. I didn't like the way that that worked. It just kind of looked funky. I like the way that the Kraken exits, and in my kind of research, I found that the Kraken actually outperforms the competitors. So I'm gonna go ahead and give that a try. And then, of course, we have our GTX 1080 Ti from EVGA. There are a lot of variations of this. I believe this is the SC2 model. So I'm excited to see what kind of performance gains we might get out of comparing the 1080 to the 1080 Ti. We may, in another video, even do a test between the two different processors. So make sure you subscribe to our channel here because we will come back with some more videos besides just what we're doing here. So we're going to go ahead and get started on that build. All of this is going into a Corsair 400Q series case, which is kind of a no-frills case, but I like it that way. It's sound deadened, and that was what's important to me, is just a nice, quiet running PC. So we're going to go ahead and start on that build, and then at the end, we'll come back and see what we ended up with. Thank you. I'm back. I have that PC built. I got it built actually yesterday, as you saw in the time lapse. I wanted to get it booted up and start to kind of actually get it configured, but I ran into an initial problem. When I would power it up, it would basically get through the RAM check, and then at the end of the RAM check, it would restart. It would actually shut down and then start up again. And so it was kind of going through this like pre-boot loop, and it got stuck in that. So what we did was we removed the RAM, tried booting, putting one stick of RAM in there, weren't having any luck with the RAM that I had. So we decided, well, let's try RAM from another machine. We tried RAM from James's machine and was actually able to get it to boot. So we realized that the RAM was an issue. So before actually going and deciding to return the RAM and order new RAM, we also decided to update the BIOS on the motherboard. And after updating the BIOS on the motherboard, by downloading the BIOS update from another system and then USB installing it, we were actually able to get that RAM to work. So that BIOS update must have provided, even though it didn't list it in the change log, it did give us the ability to run that RAM. And now I'm running that RAM at default clock speed. I haven't messed with overclocking anything, the RAM or the CPU or even the GPU. We're just running it and configured. So we got Windows installed on there. We actually installed that from a Windows USB stick that James had. It was a little bit older of a version, so I had to run lots of software updates, which was a little odd, and then of course getting all the drivers and everything installed. And by the end of the day, the PC was running and I was able to start using it as intended, which is fantastic. So today I spent a little bit of time on that PC just getting some of the software installed and configured the way that I use it. I still haven't gone through and really done anything as far as trying to customize any of the hardware or make any changes there. I'm just really wanting to get that to a point where I can start to produce from it. And then we'll probably come back in a little while with a video where we actually look at its performance in comparison to, you know, some other stuff that we have available to us. So overall, I'm really impressed. I feel like this build went a lot better than my last build. There were a couple moments of frustration there, of course. As you saw in the time lapse, there were some times when all of us had our hands in that PC, kind of looking and trying to get things figured out. But nonetheless, the build went really well, and the PC is running and everything is great. So overall, I'm pretty impressed with the process and everything. So there are some things that I definitely did learn through this process and actually the last time I built a PC. And so I'm putting together a video that are the five things that I learned from building a PC. And I think that they are maybe important for somebody to watch that is thinking about building their first PC. Obviously, there's a lot of good resources out there around that topic. But if you wanted to check out what I have to say about it, make sure to take a look at that too. So we have some stuff that we're just going to throw up in this video just for you to see, but we'll come back with maybe more of a comprehensive review of this PC build with the Threadripper platform just after we have some time to, you know, edit some projects, render out, spend some time actually using the PC. We can come back with something a little bit more more useful or more real world than just basic benchmarks. So make sure to subscribe to our channel for that and click this thumbs up. Give us a thumbs up here if you like this video. Make sure to check out that five things video, which I'll link to in the description below. Thanks so much for checking out this video. We hope to see you back here soon.